In this circuit, transistor Q1 and Q2 are matched and have equal current gains and base emitter voltage. Therefore, their base as well as their collector currents assume to be equal. With this assumption, the reference current flowing through the resistor R can be calculated by subtracting the 10 volt from the base emitter voltage and dividing it by the resistor R. And with the anode equation, we can determine the current flowing through the collector of the transistors Q1 and Q2. Now, as we can see here, the current IC2 consists of currents flowing through the emitter of transistors Q3 and Q4. And for this circuit, we would like to have a balanced emitter currents. By the way, if you like what you are watching, please hit the like button. Also, subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. Now back to the video. The transistors Q3 and Q4 are configured as a differential pair, which in most designs, it consists of two matched transistors with equal emitter currents. However, in this example, the transistor Q3 has a twice current gain beta as transistor Q4. Therefore, to obtain a balanced and equal current at the emitter of Q3 and Q4, we can add a resistor in series with the emitter of transistor Q3. So to determine the value of this resistor, we can simply write this voltage equation, which it is a KVL around a closed loop here. And since we would like to have an equal value for IEEE3 and IEEE4, then they can simply be obtained by dividing the IC2 by 2, so that each emitter can have a 1 milliamp current. We can also calculate the current flowing through the base of Q3 and Q4 by dividing their emitter currents by their beta. And by putting everything together in the voltage equation here, and solving it for the emitter resistor RE, we will obtain 275 ohm for RE. I have other videos in reviewing BJT circuits, which I will put the links under the video description.